Hi, everybody. Welcome to Harmon Speaks. I've been getting a lot of questions about how does a guy with no hands and no feet drive? Well, the short answer to that is dangerously. But why don't you hop in and we'll find out. Come on in. We'll give it a try. As I get into the car, first thing I do, I let off the emergency brake because I really can't reach that in the car. Secondly, I put in my keys because if I can't drop them, I will. Turn the car on. I'm a classic rock guy, so I'll turn that down so you can hear it. You'll notice I put my seatbelt on before I get into the car. My arm is very short, and my belly is not. So I put this on before I get into the car. There we go. If you don't mind giving that door a shove. Thank you, sir. Welcome to the love machine. When I drive, my car has no alternative equipment on it at all. I don't need a lift. I don't have to have pedals that are special or anything for the hands that are special. I am required by Tennessee law to drive an automatic transmission, which I have. I have driven a straight shift, but you really don't want a guy with one hand trying to do that. It just doesn't work well. And I have to have either power steering or rack and pinion steering, which I believe Hondas have rack and pinion. I'm not sure what the difference is. I don't know much about cars. Alright, so I put it in gear, and I have the backup mirror. I did not have that added. It was came with the car. This is a 2014 model. I bought it about a year ago. I've had two of these cars, and my first one gave out on me after a lot of miles, so I got another one. I drive only with the left hand, really. If I'm going a straight distance, I'll hold on to both, but and I have to pull this down with my arm. Nope, cars are coming. As I pointed out, I am a bad driver, so hang on. Prayer is always a good thing when you ride with me.
That's great for the passenger.
Yeah, I hope you don't. I don't worry.
I like a good adventure.
Yeah, don't worry too much.
No.
I've only killed a few people.
Oh, so. Well, just a few.
And nobody I really like. So
oh,
you'll
good.
Be okay.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, here we go. There we go. See, right, we pulled out. Nobody's coming. We're all alive. Okay.
Now, I do have a question.
Go
since
for
you,
it.
Since you drive with one hand.
Okay.
What about roads that are extremely curvy that sometimes require two hands? How do you handle stuff
well,
like
gotta
that?
You got to be good at it. You know, I just learned to use the wheel with one hand. The other one doesn't reach.
Right.
I mean, it just flat out doesn't reach.
Right.
So, this is not going to work. There are, I've been in vehicles where the seat is closer and I can do that, but it doesn't really help me. Mm-hmm. I can't get a grip on the wheel, so it doesn't really help. What I do is I am smart enough to slow down.
Mm-hmm.
So, I drive slowly and just make sure that the one hand I have keeps the wheel under control. So, I drive like I am now.
No Mario Andretti for you.
I do like to drive fast, but not on the curvy, wet road.
No.
I used to drive more dangerously, but I got old. I have children now, and I know they would really love to have my insurance money, but no! You have to put up with me instead.
So I didn't know that it was a state law that I guess handicapped drivers or whatever have
right.
to have automatic transmission.
Yeah, they don't describe us that way, but basically,
right.
if you do not have functioning hands or feet, there are certain requirements.
Interesting.
Yeah, now when I was a child and when I first got my driver's license, it was a requirement that I have a knob on the wheel. So I would hold on to the knob and drive. And I never liked that. And one day, while I was driving, I pulled off of my street onto another street, and the knob rolled out of my hand. And I came very close to hitting this sweet little old lady. And thank God I did not, and got control of the car. And I drove immediately to the driving station. And I went inside, took off the knob of the wheel, and I went inside, and I asked to speak to one of the state troopers who was there. And I talked to him, and I told him what had just happened. And I said, I don't know what we can do about it, but I don't want to use this knob. And he sat there for a moment, looked at me, and he said, may I see your license, please? And I gave him the license, and he said, you can just keep the knob, I'll be back in just a moment. And he walked off. So I waited, and a few minutes later, he came back out. And I thought he was going to take my license forever, but he came back out, and he gave my license back, and he said, look on the back. And I looked, and he had taken the requirement of my having a knob off the license. And I said, I don't have to use it anymore. And he said, that's right. He said, I think you ought to know better than the state of Tennessee what you need. So if you don't want to use the knob, don't use the knob. And I thanked him for that. And he said, if you really want to thank me, don't run over any old ladies. And I laughed, and I thanked him, and off I went. So I have paid him back by never running over any old ladies and tried to drive safely.
So basically, I guess the misconception for people is that, I'm trying to word this perfectly. People with fiscal difference can drive. There's pretty much, there's some things that, there's not anything you can't do. It just takes careful preparation and careful execution.
Right. Now, you know, that's going to vary with the person, of course. But my dad taught me how to drive, and my dad was a Marine, so there was some assumption I would be dead before I got my license. But my dad taught me, we had an S-shaped driveway, and we got in the car, and we had bushes on either side of the driveway. And he said, what I want you to do is to back out of the driveway. When you can back all the way to the end of it without hitting any of the bushes, I'll let you drive forward. And I must have backed out of that driveway a million times, but I finally learned how to do it. And then he started letting me go forward. So, you know, I was taught how to drive. And I was taught to be careful and take my time and do what I have to do. And I think most people with a physical difference can learn to drive. Now, some may not, but most can. And there are many vehicles that are adjusted for whatever they might need. So there's that as well. I'm just fortunate that I don't need that.
How do you handle long trips when you drive?
I can do it. As I get older, that becomes a little more difficult. My leg gets tireder as I get older. And fortunately, my wife likes to drive too, and she will help me out, but I can't do it. And I like traveling. I don't always love driving, but I like traveling. So I can do it. We don't miss many bathrooms, but I can do it, so. And of course, I have my children in the back saying, are we there yet? Are we there yet? Are we there yet? And my door's locked from the inside, so I always say, yeah, we're here, get out. And drives my wife a little crazy. But they're smart enough not to get out of a moving vehicle. And there we have it. One other thing, I have to turn the wheel before I turn the car off, because if this part is going this way, I can't reach the key. So I turn off the key. Turn off the ignition, and there we have it, and we're here.
Perfect.
Thank you for watching Harman Speeds today. I hope you've liked this video. If you have, please go and subscribe. Make us part of the family. Also, feel free to hit the notification code so you'll be notified whenever we load up a video. And please like this, and give me comments about what you like, what you don't like. you know, what you would like to see us cover as a topic. We're really trying to change the way the world sees people with physical differences, so please help us out. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Thanks for watching our videos today and the other videos that we've done. We're very proud of what we're doing, and we're trying to make a difference in the world. If you like what we're trying to do and you support us, please hit the subscribe button. Please also hit the bell. That will let you know whenever the videos are uploaded. And also like them so we know you like what we're doing. Make a comment if you need to. Let us know what you think and what you'd like to see on this channel. One more thing, we'll put the email address on the screen. Please write me if you need to speak about these issues. Thank you and have a nice day.